Hello, 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 everybody. Hey, how you doing? It's Friday night. Yes. So, we're going to be doing our Hello Spring Rockin' Robin. Oh, yeah. Say hello if you're painting with me tonight. Let me know who's painting with you, and we'll get this party started. Got the tunes going, right? That's what I'm talking about. So, my name is Eve. This is Eve's Creations Paint Party, coming to you from my humble abode. Let me show you the weapons this evening. So, we are going to be using Big Boy. He is a 1-inch flat. We have Fluffy in the house. It is an old beat-up bristly brush. Very stiff bristles. Medium-sized. Okay, we have Tiny. He is a small round for the details. And we have a Mini-Me. He looks just like Big Boy, except he's really small. All these brushes go in your water. Unless we're going to use them, clean them when I instruct you to. You're going to swirl. You're going to tap. You're going to dab on your paper towel. You want your bristles to be wet but not dripping. Alrighty, so let's say hi to our man of the hour, the Butters. Butt is in the house. So, because he sometimes likes to chime in. So, let's say hi to our buddy boy. Hi, Butters. Hi, buddy. He's such a good boy. There he is. There's my little man. He's such a good boy. So, say hello, hello, hello. Hey, Diane. Diane from Graham, Washington. She's in the house. Jack is here. How you doing, darling? I sent a lot of people your website last couple times, and I hope you're getting a bigger following, my friend. The Muscular Doctor, for instance. Thank you so much for that, Jack. Share, share, share away. That's what we like. Thank you so much. I hope you're feeling much better. Hello, hello, hello. Cinder in the house. Cinder's got more glitter. That's what I'm talking about. Hello, 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 everybody. Happy Friday. So it is always free to watch. Tips are appreciated. I'm going to post that link in the comment section. I have PayPal, Venmo, and Cash App in the house. Let me find where that post is. There it is. Bam. Found it. All right, I'm going to pour my paint. Same colors every single party. Black, white, red, blue, and yellow. So, let's get this party started. I'm going to pour my paint. Say hello, hello, hello. Because you know how much I love doing roll call. Let me start writing some of this down. Because you know I can't remember a thing. Jack is here. So glad you're here, Jack. Cinder's in the house. Kim and Ella. Hi, Ella. Hi, love. How you doing, darling? And Peggy. Peggy, my friend. Megna's here. Hi, Megna. We have Sanvi and Nikhil painting with Megna tonight. Hi, Sanvi. Hi, Nikhil. So excited. So excited. Hello, hello, hello. I hope I got those names right. So, no creepers out there. Make sure you say hi if you're painting with us tonight. All right, let me put you in your handy dandy holder so you can get a look at the picture we're painting tonight. All right, so this is on. Hi, Lisa. Long time no see. Hi, Christina. Long time no see. Hi, guys. So, hi, Ginny. Ginny and Audrey, granddaughter. Ginny and granddaughter Audrey. Hi, Audrey. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. So, this is a 10 by 20 canvas. Okay, I'm holding it straight up and down, so it's 10 this way, 20 this way. If you're working on something larger or smaller, just adjust accordingly. As long as you're in about the same area of your canvas that I am, you will be fine. All right, I can't show you both at once, so if you need a reference photo, screenshot, and then you have a reference photo to look at. We're going to be doing all sorts of fun stuff. Think of your colors. Think of what color flowers you want. Think of what color birdhouse you want. Are you going to do a robin? Are you going to do something different? It is your world, your painting. You do it any way you want to do it, all right? So this is where, so I'm going to give a few more minutes for people to say hello, hello, hello. and we'll get started. I'm going to pour my paint. I'm going to grab my Java. I'm going to lower the music so you can hear me. Getting ready, getting all fueled up. You know me and my coffee. That's for sure. So I want to give you guys a sneak peek for next Friday. I started next Friday's painting. I'm going to give you a sneak peek of what that's all about. I think you're going to like it. It's going to be a nod to Mother's Day. So for next Friday, this is what we're doing. Next Friday in the house. That is going to be the painting. Since so many people are asking me for landscapes, I figured I would give you landscapes. Hey, hey, Lynn is here from Ohio. Hi, Lynn. Vetch is creeping. Hey, Vetch, how you doing, love? That's okay if you're creeping. I don't mind. Hey, Patty, how you doing? My cousin Patty's on here too tonight. Hi, Patty. Hi, Vetch. Hello, hello, hello. So, I'm so excited to see you, Vetch. Vetch is an amazing woman, everybody. She is a teacher for our high school, so she's been keeping our kids edumacated. You're going to be here for next week? Sounds good, hon. Sounds good. Can't wait. Can't wait. And if you need supplies, let me know. All right, I'm going to pour my paint, everybody. Everybody say hi. One big happy family going on here. Let's get this party started. Sorry I'm late. I had to hit buttons. we got some spammers coming on tonight. So guys, seriously, on a serious note, if you don't see, when you see the post, if it doesn't say me, if it doesn't say Eve's Creations Paint Party or from Kristen, and it's talking about tickets or how to join or signing in or anything like that, don't click on it. It's spam. It's not for me. Unfortunately, I get bombarded with some spammers, and I try to stay on top of things and delete them and ban them, but they do sneak in there. So make sure you're paying attention. Make sure you're not clicking on anything to join that has to do with credit cards, signing in, your email. I don't ask for any of that. So let's take the power back from these spammers. You know what I'm saying? Let's take the power back. That's why I was a little late coming on tonight, because I had to hit buttons from the spammers. I had to delete them. Because they're trying to sneak in on us. And that's not good. We don't want any of those sneaky peeps sneaking in on us. That's for sure. That is for sure. So unfortunately, you know, it's part of the world we live in, and that's what's going to happen. I just don't want to see you guys get yourselves into any trouble or to share anything. So, any of your private information. So just remember that. Just remember that if you don't see a post and it's from me, and it's saying to, like, log in and click here for tickets and all that kind of stuff, don't do it. Don't do it. They're sneaky. They'll try to get you. So just make sure you're paying attention to who the post is from. All right, because we don't want anybody getting hacked. Bye, Lisa. See you soon, hon. Angela, what size canvas are you using? This is a 10 by 20. Hello, Angela. Welcome to the fam. See you soon, Vetch. Love you bunches. Thank you, Jack. Yes, Tom Ziver is in the house. Tom Ziver is definitely in the house. Angela's here. Hello, 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 everybody. Hello, hello, hello. all my brave souls. Rockin' Robin didn't scare you away. So, same colors every single party. We have white. We have black. We have blue. Yellow. And red. All right here. Hi, Deneen. Hi, love. Missed you, girl. Missed you, girl. Yeah, we are definitely getting attacked by spam tonight, everybody. So just pay attention, all right? Just keep your guard up. Hey, hey, Deneen. How you doing, sweetheart? Keep your guard up, guys. Let's get started. Let's get started. Hi, Aaliyah. Hello, love. How you doing? That sounds awesome, Aaliyah. Yep, so... you guys, the replays are always available, so of course you can watch it anytime and you can paint along at any time. So we're going to get this party started here. We're going to get this party started, the almighty blank canvas. And no worries, right? Because we're going to tackle it with our almighty brushes. And we're going to do amazing things tonight because you guys are all amazing. 6,000%. 6,000% amazing. Okay, so the first thing you guys are going to do is you're going to grab your paint, and we're going to go into brown. So, swirl, tap, dab, big boy. And to make brown, you want to grab your red, your yellow, little tiny smidge of black, because we're going for a dark brown tonight, and some white. Right, you're going to mix that all together. When you mix that all together, you are going to get a brown. Okay, so we want a darker brown. And this is like really, really light, so I'm going to add more black to it. Right, so when you mix your colors, you just do little bits at a time. Do little bits at a time because you can always add to it. You can always add to it. And when you pull your paint, when you scoop your paint, make sure that you're scooping from the sides of your little paint globs here, so you're not wasting any paint. Okay, so I want that to be a little bit darker, so I'm going to grab a little more black. I'm going to grab a little more black. We're going to mix this in. Alrighty, going to definitely mix this in. Okay, and what you're going to do is you're going to hold your brush right up against your canvas. You're going to go on either side of your canvas, right on the edges. Put your brush perpendicular. You're going about two fingers in, two fingers in on either side, right? So here, boop, and here, boop. You want to hold your brush perpendicular to canvas. We're not stressing this too much because we're going to be going over this, and it's a tree, and you're just going to pull swoop, straight down. All right, scan on the other side. Right, I'm holding my brush back here, straight up against the canvas, about two fingers in, and I'm going to pull whoop, straight down. All right, now color those in. Color those in. So this whole picture is kind of framed in. It's framed out by two big trees on either end of the picture. So that is what you just made. And as you're filling it in, if you need to fix your line a little bit, fix your line a little bit. That's all. That is all. That's all you need to do. Just fix up that line. And if you're painting your sides, paint your sides. It's all good. It's all good. And if you go out of your line when you're filling it in, just make a new line. You know how I am. You know how I love coloring in the lines. Right? Not. That's a knot. And they're my own lines, and I still can't color inside of them. So I'm just pulling my brush nice and flat and smooth. smoothing that out. I'm not worried about my line being perfectly straight because it's a tree. Trees aren't perfectly straight. They're not perfectly straight. All right, now I'm going to do the other side. Going to color in the other side. That's all. That's all we're doing. And if you, you know, if you, as you're filling it in, use the flat of that brush. Pull it nice and flat. And you could fix the, you know, your outer edge if you need to by pulling this nice and flat. Just getting it on there. We're just getting it on there. Nice and flat. And turn your brush and smooth that down like this if you need to. Whatever you need to do. Whatever you need to do. There we go. Pull this down. Right? And if you jump over your line, that's all right. I already did it like 3 times. I already jumped over it 3 times. So, Aaliyah, are you telling me that you want a funky chicken as a paint party? Is that what you were saying to me, love? Is that what you're saying to me? Next week, we're going to have the ducks in the pond. I'll show everybody again as you guys log in. And are you telling me you want to do a funky chicken? Or is that somebody else that's doing a funky chicken? Okay, so once you have that done, you're going to swirl tap dab your brush, get all the brown out of it, and we're going to fill in this space with blue. We're going to fill in the space in the middle with light blue. So far tonight, I have Diane, Jack, Cinders here, Kim with Ella, Peggy's hanging on, Megna's with her friends Sandy and Nikhil, we have Ginny in the house with her granddaughter Audrey, Lynn is here from Ohio, Angela and Aaliyah, Vex stopped in to say hi. So that's all good stuff. Got good things going on. Say hello, hello, hello if you're painting with us tonight. Oh, that's all right, Aaliyah. I did a how-to birds video. So if you look in my videos listed, there's a how-to birds. So if you need help... Oh, I get what you're saying. You're going to do a funky chicken when you try to paint the robin because your birds come out funny looking. I got it now. Took a minute. Took a minute. But I understand what you're saying. Yeah, your robin's going to be fine, honey. You're going to, you know, and if it looks like a funky chicken, we'll just own it and say it's art. That's all there is to it. We'll just own it and say it's art. Got it. All right, swirl tap dab that big boy brush. Get all those browns out of there. Make them nice and clean. Make them nice and clean. And now you're going to... I got it. It took me a minute. Oh, geez. All right, so we're just going to grab blue and white. Blue and white. And come in here and you're going to fill this in. I'm going to fill this in, okay? And when you go next to where your trees are, just be a little bit careful. Right? Because you don't want to turn around and pick up that brown. So when you're going where the side of your tree is, just be a little careful about it. Just be a little careful about it. That's all. Right? Just pull your brush nice and flat. Go down your edge. Right? You just want to be a little careful. No big deal. No big deal. And if there's a piece you need to fix, then fix it. Right? If a side of your tree needs to be fixed, then fix it. You can fix it. Alright, so I'm just going straight up and down with my nice, pretty light blue color. Nice sky blue color. Filling in the rest of the canvas with this. We're filling in the rest of the canvas. Going nice and slow, pulling my brush nice and flat along the edges of the tree. Right? Nice and easy. Easy peasy lemon squeezy here, guys. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. As we make our funky chickens. I like that, Aaliyah. I like that I got the joke. And hello, 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 Cynthia. Hi, sweetheart. Hello, everybody. All All right, so this is your sky. You can make it as dark as you or as light as you want it to be. It's all up to you. Okay, and we're just filling this in. Okay, going nice and careful down the edge of my tree. Right, if I pick up a little bit of brown, that's all right. You can blend it right out. If a little bit of your tree color gets on your brush, that's okay. Just turn around and smoosh it right out into your sky. You're not even going to see it. All right, so we're doing clouds tonight, guys. I did a how-to video on clouds. All right, so I'm going to show you here how to do clouds again. And don't stress them. Don't stress them because no one's going to be paying attention to the clouds once the painting's done. They're not going to be paying any attention to the clouds. So we're going to keep it easy. We're going to keep it simple. Right? And that's it. Hi, Tammy. Hello, Sue B. Hi, hon. Sue B the newbie from United Kingdom. We're international, baby. Welcome to the fam, Sue B. Sue is back. Sue is back for more torture. Hello, Tammy. How you doing, sweetheart? Hi, hon. How are you? All right. Hi, sweetheart. All right, so we're going to swirl, tap, dab our fluffy because we want to do this while this is still wet. All right, so you don't want to wait too long. You want to do this while this is still wet, and with your fluffy brush, you're going to mash it into your paper towel and make sure it's nice and fluffy. Okay? It's a stiff bristled brush that has bristles going in every direction, and that's what we like. And you're going to grab some clean white. All right, so make sure you have some clean white. We're going to grab some clean white because you want to do this while it's still wet. So that's why I'm jumping right into this. All right, you're going to smush the white into your brush. You're going to, wherever you want your clouds to be, okay? And you're just going to very light touch and just do a circular motion. Okay, just do a circular motion. And yes, this is going to blend out into your sky color. We want that. We want it to blend out. We want I'll figure out how to talk, people. It's okay. We want it to blend out into our sky color. So that is all good. And I am just doing a circular motion with my brush. I'm going down. I'm going up. Right? We're not going to do straight lines, and we're just doing these little circular puffs. And yes, we want it to blend out. We want the sky color to take over and make these a light blue. Okay, we want that to happen. Okay, and you're just doing little puffs. All right, and I'm going to put my other set of clouds down here. And I'm just grabbing white paint. And if you notice, I'm just doing a circular motion. That's all I'm doing. I'm going down. I'm going up. I'm making all these little puffs. That's what I'm doing. Little puffs. Puff. That's right. Okay, and if you go into your tree, that's fine. We're going to fix those edges later. So don't worry about that. Right? If you notice, I'm going down, I'm going up, I'm doing all these fun little funky things here. Okay? Oh, no, Tammy. Oh, poor things. All right, we have to send prayers out to Tammy's kids. Unfortunately, they're down with the sickness here. So, lots and lots of prayers for your family, Tammy. Yes. Yes, Magna, I am going fast because when you guys are done with your sky, I want you to do this step immediately. Your sky still needs to be wet. So I'm going to show you this step, and then I'm going to give you some time to catch up mustard, all right? So on my third set, my third cloud is going to be down the bottom. So you're just going to swirl. You're going to puff up. You're going to puff down. Yes, prayers. Prayers to you and your family, Tammy. I'm glad you're doing okay. And I hope they recover real soon. Real soon. Thank you so much for that, Sue. That's right. Let's support each other as a family, guys. That's what we're do here. That's what we do here. So I know I did this part very quickly if you're still working on your sky. But I wanted to show you so you do this step while your sky is still wet. Okay? So, and now you guys have a chance to catch up mustard because we're going to let that dry. Well, there you go, Tammy. That's the bright side right there. That's the bright side, right? So you get to stay home and watch over the kids, and you get all this time to paint, and you just take it easy. That's all you can do in times like these. Just take it easy. We're just taking it easy. That's all we need. That's all we can do, right? So no worries here. I got you. I understood what you were saying. I understood what you were saying, sweetie. Very true, Sue Burns. Very true. Times like these, we have to look to the positives. If we get all caught up in the negatives, then we're gonna have a hard time of it. You know, we all have to focus on those little positives in life. We have to focus on those little positives in life, because if we don't, we'll just get stuck all in that mucky, mucky negative stuff, and we're not going to have any fun at all. Wow, my hair is a mess. I'm a mess tonight. I did put on the make-em-ups, though. All right. So, as soon as you're done with your sky, you guys take this time to catch up. Mustard, I want you to do all these swirls. I want you to go up. I want you to go down. I want you to go into a circular motion. Okay? All these puffs, and it's going to mix in with your sky color, and we want that to happen. We want that to happen. Okay. I have no idea where. Oh, my paper towels fell on the floor. That's what happened to them. I lost my paper towels, people. All right, so we're going to be working with browns, guys. So get your browns out. You know, especially if you're doing the robin, the brown, or I'm going to show you how to make them with your colors. So we're going to be make yourselves a ton of brown if you're waiting. I'm going to make myself some more brown. So I'm just swirl tap dabbing my big boy brush, and I'm going to grab that red that I did before, and that yellow, and that little bit of black, and I'm going to use that mucky white I got going on here. Okay, so mix yourself a ton of brown if you're waiting for everybody else to catch up mustard, all right, guys? Because I always wind up not mixing enough, and then I have to mix more, and then the color isn't matching up to what I want. So make yourself a nice big pile, and you want this to be a dark brown. So if it's not looking dark enough, just keep adding more black in small increments. Just keep adding more black in small little increments to get it darker, all right? So until you get the color that you want. And if it's looking too gray, add more red and add more yellow to it. So if it's looking a little on the gray side, add more red and add more yellow. All right? Okay, so you want like a base brown color. That's what we're going to do. That's what we're going to do. We need it for our trees. We need it for our funky robin chicken. I totally love that. Now that I got the joke, I totally love it. Oh, 6,000%. Totally love it, Aaliyah. I'm there with you, girl. Alright, so now what you want to do with this brown is you're going to go back in, right? Wipe your brush off because it's probably very globby right now. So I'm going to wipe the brush off here. And I'm going to grab that brown. And I'm going to grab a little bit of black. Okay? So I'm grabbing brown and a little bit of black. Black and some brown. And I'm just smushing a little bit. I don't want it to all mix together. I want it all different colors on my brush. And you're going to go back in and you're going to fix your edges of your tree. So I'm just swooping right back down again. I'm going to fix that edge. And I'm going to fill it in. Just here, you know, just lightly swiping with my brush. And I'm going to turn my brush this way. Okay, and then turn it this way and having all those different colors. Now this is just a light swipe because you might have to fix your edge again once you do your cloud. So we're just doing a quick little swipe because these trees have a few layers on them. And I want to get the break of color. I want the colors to separate. So you're going to kind of just real quick stick and move. Do this like really fast. And with those colors separated on your brush, it's going to make all these amazing things happen. So those of you who are waiting for everyone else to catch up mustard, you can turn around and put another layer on your tree. If you didn't get to this part, that's okay, because we're going to do it again, and you might have to do it once you're, you know, when you do your cloud, if you wind up going over on your tree again when you're doing your clouds. So don't stress it. If you didn't get to doing this, that's fine. That's fine, because we're going to go back over and add some more to these trees. I just figured since I mixed the brown paint and it was on my brush, I might as well use it to fill it in. Alright, so you want to make sure you have clean white paint, and you want to make sure that you have your fluffy, nice and fluffy. Okay, so when you're done doing this first step, you want to swirl, tap, dab your fluffy, get all the globs and the blues out of it, and you want to make sure you have clean white paint for the next step, all right, guys? And those of you who missed it, once I find it, I don't know what I did with it. I put the painting down for next week, and now I can't find it. Oh, there it is. Next week, guys. So a lot of you have been asking me for landscapes and have been asking me for fences with flowers. So this isn't finished. I'm going to finish it up tonight, and we have our little duckling family going on. So next week, next Friday, you'll see the post for the event soon. I already started the painting. I love these colors. So when you guys come back for more torture, this is going to be next Friday. And we have to talk about How To Tuesday. What do you guys want to see for How To Tuesday? I think the last time we left off, it's going to be wings. So are you guys totally awesome with wings for How To Tuesday? Let me know, all right? All different types of wings. Bird wings, fairy wings, angel wings, insect wings, all sorts of wings going on. Alright, so I swirl tap dab my fluffy. I mashed it. Oh, awesome, Lynn, right? It's really cute. So I mashed it. I made sure it's nice and fluffy. I'm going into my clean white. And I'm barely grabbing any paint at all. I'm just doing a little touch into there. I'm not kerplunking it. Small amount of paint. And then I'm just going to mush it. I'm going to mush it into the brush. Take some of that out. Right? I love the duckies too. Sue B, right? They're cute little ducks. Are you there, mama? Because I'm quackers. That's right, sweetheart. That's right. It's a little nod to Mother's Day. That's why I'm doing the family. I might add some more critter families in there. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. So extremely light touch. You want to go back to your puffs. I'm going to do the middle one so you can see it better because the top one's kind of got a shadow on it from my light. That's awesome, Sue. I love you. Wings sounds good, Cynthia. All right, cool beans. Cool beans. That's what we'll do. So very, very light touch on your puffs, right? You see how you made these circular things with your puffs? You want to go to the top of your puff, and you're just going to create these wisps. So just the top of the puff here, right? Just the top of the puff. You're just going to create these little wisps. And then once you put that on there, you're going to pull the brush and just lightly, very, very lightly, so you have the separation of color, you're going to pull that into the rest of your cloud. So it's very little paint, very, very small amount of paint, all into the bristles of my brush. And on all these puffs, I'm just going to do, with a very light touch, I'm just going to do these little wisps. Wisps. It's one of those words I can't say very well. So you're just going to do these little wisps. And you want to make sure you're leaving that blue color in your clouds. Don't cover it all up. You want that separation with the blue color, okay, guys? You want that separation. So make sure you're leaving those spaces of the blue color. Right, and as you work your way down, those circles that you made, you're just following the lines of the circles. So I'm using what I call Fluffy. He is a beat up old bristly brush, and he's medium in size. See, Aaliyah, he's a beat up old bristly brush. He's very stiff in the bristles, so they go in every direction. So if you bought my kit, there's three Fluffies in it, so that's the one I'm using. You got to beat them up before you use them. And if you're painting at home with your own supplies, any stiff bristled brush that kind of looks like one you'd want to throw away, that's what we're using. Yes, Subi, like crisps. I can't say that either. Wisps and crisps. So you're just going to turn around and do these circular motions. And if you notice, I am leaving that dark in there. I'm leaving that dark in there, and I'm using a very small amount of paint. Very small amount of paint. So you want to kind of put that white right on the top of your little circle. And then just wisps. Just doing flicking your brush like this. Just pull it down. Right? So you're pressing harder on the top to get a nice bright top part that's harder. And you want these lines to stay fuzzy up here. They don't have to be perfect lines because clouds are fluffy. So you press a little harder here. And then as you work your way down, you want to go lighter and lighter with your touch. Okay? That's what you want to do. All right? So you're going to do that on all three sets of your clouds. So I'm going to come down to the clouds that are down here now. Right? I'm going to push a little harder, get that line right on the top of my circle. And then very lightly, I'm just going to follow that shape and bring it down. Right? And then I'm going to just go back up there and very lightly soften that out. I'm hardly touching. I'm doing very soft touches, and I want this all to be very, very soft because clouds are soft. And if you notice, I didn't grab any more paint just now when I went to do the other one. I pressed a little harder here, and then as I do my little flicks, I'm just going to fill that in, and I'm leaving those blues in there. All right, let's see if we can get one more out of the paint on my brush. So I'm going on top, I'm pressing harder to get that piece. Then I'm going to softly go over it to fluff it out. And then I'm just going to do these little flicks into the rest of that puff. Okay, so if you saw me, I did three puffs without even getting any more paint. It's a very small amount of paint. Okay. Now, press hard for that initial curve. Go under it with all these little flicks and soften it out. Okay, soften it out. Next one. Press harder for that first initial curve and do all these little flicks and soften it out. Soften it out. Okay, and I'm just mushing here, there, not everywhere, like with hardly having any paint on the brush at all. I'm just kind of mushing around to give more of a softness. So, like, my brush right now hardly doesn't have any paint on it, and I'm just kind of mushing them around. Thanks, Subi. Right, so top, I'm gonna push, and then I'm just gonna do soft, 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 soft. All right, one more set of clouds to do. And if you mess these up, you can easily paint them out. Just add blue with your big boy and paint them right out. They're not necessary for the painting if you want to, you know, go hardcore. And another thing you want to remember is that you're not going to notice these. When you looked at my painting, you noticed the birdhouse and the robin. You didn't notice the clouds in the background unless you were looking for them. All right, so a nice push of a line there. Follow my arching, soft little wispy flicks. And then I'm just going to go up and soften that top line. Okay, so the trick is hardly any paint. Hardly any paint. Okay, and you want to leave those separations of the blue here. So don't paint all over that blue completely. Because we could always add more paint. You can't take paint off. Well, you can a little bit, but, you know, just a little swipe or something if you screw up. You can't, like, take it off. All right, so filling these in. If you notice, I'm holding my brush like a pencil. I'm just kind of doing little wispy motions like this, little circular motions. Getting a nice dark white line on the top. And then just flicking around and softening that out. Just softening that out. So this all has to do with the amount of paint you have on your brush. I wish I was in everybody's houses. I wish I could go to your house and be like, that's too much paint. That's too much paint. So you're going to have to gauge for yourselves, guys, all right? And if you do one and it's like a big glob of paint, just spread it around. Wipe your brush off and then just go to that glob of paint and just spread it around with a brush that doesn't have anything on it at all right? So if you wound up putting like a big glob of paint, you know, just wipe that brush off, and then you could turn around and smush that around. You could smush that big glob of paint around, okay? No worries. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, everybody. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So, you want to hear an amazing story? Last week, we had a family painting with us, and it was Logan and Connor and the baby girl was painting with us, and the mom sent me a message. I didn't realize it, but Logan, who's a teenager now, actually came to in person to two of my paint parties when he was little, and she sent me the pictures of him standing with his paintings and when he was little. So he was like, one time he was like 8, another time he was like 10. And if that didn't warm my heart, I don't know what to tell you. It was the most amazing thing ever. It was so adorable. And I didn't realize when he was on the live video that it was the kid that I painted with. It was such an amazing feeling. I just wanted to share that with you guys. Like, next time they're on as a family, I'll have to let you guys know so you can say hi to them. He was awesome. It was awesome. All right, guys, ketchup mustard. We're going to be using Big Boy next. And you guys know our favorite married couple. We have to send prayers to her, okay? And I don't know if I'm telling her business or not, but I'm going to do it anyway because I'm so excited. I know, right, Aaliyah? I'm telling you, I didn't even realize that he painted with me before. And it totally warmed my heart when the mom sent me the photos of him being a little spud, just a little guy. So, and now he's on the lot. They come on the lives with us, so it was amazing. So our favorite married couple, Hannah and Dustin, we haven't seen Hannah in a really, really long time because she is, right, Subi? So Hannah is going to be bringing a little one into the world. So she hasn't been on our lives because she's dealing with the morning sickness, or the evening sickness, or the queasy sickness, right? And so she's going to be bringing a little one into our world. So that was so exciting news. She reached out to me today. And so Hannah and Dustin, those were our favorite married couple. Those are the ones that painted with put the chihuahuas into every painting. So that was really exciting too. That was really nice to know. And I hope she doesn't get mad at me because I just shared her news. But I'm so excited for them. So excited. They first painted with us on their 1 year anniversary. So Megna knows all about it. So we have a roll call while you guys are catching up mustering. Let's get some creepers out of here. We have Diane. We have Jack in the house. Cinder's here. Kim is with Ella. Hi, Ella, baby. We have Peggy and Megna's with her friends, Sanby and Nikhil. We have Ginny in the house with her granddaughter, Audrey. So amazing. Lynn from Ohio. Angela's here. Aaliyah, Cynthia, Sue B, my girl, and Tammy M. Hello. Kalpana's here. Hi, Kalpana. That was like perfect timing because I just did roll call. Hi, Kalpana. How you doing, love? All right, so you're going to swirl tap that big boy, and we're going to go into those browns. All right, so the next thing we want to do is swirl tap that big boy. And we're going to grab that brown paint, and we're going to put our branches, our branch for the birdhouse and our branch for the bird. Hey, Lisa. Hello, sweetheart. Lisa's here. Okay, so swirl tap that big boy. I'm doing all right, Calbana. I'm doing all right. We're painting robins tonight, or as our friend Aaliyah said, we're painting funky chickens. All right, so I'm going to grab that brown paint, nice and thin on the tip of my brush, right? Pull your brush so it's nice and thin on the tip of your brush. And you're going to come out from the side of your tree. So you want to, I'm holding my brush back here, okay? Giving a little bit of leverage. I'm going straight onto my canvas. A light touch. So at the top part of your canvas, so you're going to start about two hands down over here, and you're going to be going up like that towards the other tree. All right, so I'm going to pull along my tree. I'm going to pull along here like this, and then I'm going to bring it out at a curve, and I'm going to go up towards the other corner of the canvas. All right, so once you get that initial line in, then you can go back and grab some more brown, and you can kind of schmooze it a little bit. All right, you can schmooze it a little bit. All right, one motion, and you want this part. So when you put this, you're going to go down, all right, and this is a little thicker, and then your tree's even thicker, okay? And then where it connects to the tree, you're just going to do a little doot-doot-doot, just a little smush back and forth, that's all. All right, so that is your one branch, and the other branch that you need is going to come from the tree on the other side, so I'm going to start about a hand up, and I'm going to go towards this tree. You want to think, you want to leave space for your birdhouse, and you want to leave space for your robin, okay? So I'm going to start on the edge of the tree here. I'm going to pull up, and I'm going to churn my brush. I'll come out, and I'm going to go right off the canvas in front of the other tree. And then you want this part to be a little bit thicker. Pull that into your tree, and then just do a little shoop, 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 where the branch connects. Okay, so there you go with that. And then I'm going to make my big boy nice and thin. I'm going to wipe off any of the globs of paint. All right, I wiped them off. And I'm going to grab my brown, and I'm going to grab the smallest amount, and I'm making sure my brush is nice and thin by pulling it along my palette here. And I'm going to come up, and I'm going to put some extra little branches in. Again, you follow along the tree, and then you churn your finger like this. Show me the money move, guys. Remember, show me the money? You're churning the brush like this. See how it's churning my brush? So when you do those arches, you're churning the brush. Okay, so I'm going to follow along my trunk, churn my brush, just pull out and let it stop. So extra little branch there. And then down here, there's an extra little branch. So I'm going to follow along my trunk, I'll pull out, and I'm just going to stop. Okay, and the other little extra branches we put in with the smaller brush later.
Yes, yes it is. Upgrade to YouTube Music Premium on your app or online for ad-free music.
All right, guys, so you want to clean, you want to clean your big boy, and we're going to do mapping. We're going to map, guys, so guess what color I'm going to be using? We're going to be grabbing our white paint. So we're going to map out our house, and we're going to map out our bird. Yes, we are. That's what we're going to do. We're mapping, people. So my show opening is on Sunday, guys, my private gallery show. It's going to be this Sunday on my Eve's Artistry Facebook business page. I'm going to probably go live from the gallery to show everybody the show. So you can look for the event for that. I'm going to share the, I have the event. I shared it to the paint party page. I know this is getting to be very confusing, right? That's because I have two business pages because I am insane. So Eve's Creations Paint Party is where you guys are all right now. And I have an Eve's Artistry Facebook page for my gallery works and all of that. So I shared the event to Eve's Creations Paint Party saying the time and the place. So I'm probably going to go live from that to show everybody my gallery show and tell you the stories behind the paintings. So I'm going to post in the event page when that's going to be, what time is going to be at, and if you want to join me live, and as I walk you through my gallery show, you'll have the information to be able to do that, all right, guys? So it's going to be like a little walkthrough of my gallery show if you guys are interested. All right, so swirl tap that big boy. Actually, let's do this with a smaller brush because I want you to get this right. Hey, Nancy, how you doing? That wasn't very nice of me, right? But anyway, let's use a smaller brush. I'm going to use Mini Me, all right? Because I want you guys to get to make sure your shapes are good. And Big Boy might be a little too tricky for you. Hey, Nancy, how you doing, love? Hi, sweetheart. Hope you're doing okay. Happy Friday. Okay, Jack, so I'm going to share the event. I'll share it on the page, and I'm going to be in Island Heights. Okay, so I have my small brush. I'm going to grab just my white paint. I'm going to come over here to where this branch is, so in this sweet spot right here. And you don't want to make it too big because you want to leave this sweet spot for your robin, all right? And I'm just holding this like a pencil, and I'm going to be drawing this shape. So what I want you to do, we're making a pentagon. Ooh, scary word, right? It's just five sides. So you're going to turn around, and somewhere like in the middle of your canvas, so find your center. Make sure you're staying from this part up. And you're just going to draw a straight line. White paint. You just want to draw a straight line. Okay. And you want that line, okay, so you're going to draw a straight line just like that. Then you're going to come up at an angle off that line. So you're going to come up like an angle. And then from there, you're going to come to a point. Okay, so there is your pentagon. So you're going to draw a triangle like that, and then it's two pieces coming down like this, and then a straight line for the bottom. I'm using Mini Me. He is a number 4 shader brush. Okay, so once you have that shape in for yourself, now you can fill it in. Now, if you messed up this shape, you can just smush it out. You know, you can just grab blue paint and put it as part of your sky. You can turn around and just smush it out with your finger into your cloud. Right? So no one's going to notice, you know, if you mess part of this shape up, if you just take your finger and kind of smush it, then it disappears into your cloud and you can try again. You can try again, all right, guys? So don't stress it. And then also, as you fill it in, all right, so we're just going to fill this in with white now. We're just going to fill this in with white. That's all we're going to do. Okay? And we're using this smaller brush. Mini Me, I use kind of like a crayon. So I use him to fill in the spaces because I don't want to use my tiny brush, my pointer brush, because you're going to wind up ruining the point on it if you try to do this. So that's why I like using this small flat brush. See? Okay. So once you have that for yourself, you're going to follow this line. And you're going to pull it all the way out. Okay? And you want to stop before you hit your other tree. And I'm going to wind up hitting my tree, which is fine. The birdhouse can be in front of one of your trees. It's okay, because I made this a little bit bigger than the original house. So if you wound up in the same thing, it's fine because it could be like this branch is in front of this tree. It's no big deal. You know, if you could fit it in the sky space, that's like basically what you want. The other line, you're going to draw at an angle. It's going to follow this angle. So if you need to, do that angle for yourself, then slide your hand over and do this angle for yourself. Okay? And then you're going to turn around from that point and you're going to pull that across. Okay, so this is a straight line across coming off the bottom of our first shape. Follow this angle. So, like, you know, if you have to follow it here, you want to go down, you're going to follow it here. And then this line from the other point is meeting up with it. And then I'm going to take the top. Oh, scratch that. I want to do my other line. So this angle, right? So you want to follow this angle that you already drew. Slide your hand over. Do the same angle on this part. And then you're just going to connect it with a straight line. And just like that, you guys drew a pentagon birdhouse. All right, so the first thing I did was I made a straight line. I did two angles. I did two angles this way for a triangle. I followed this straight line and brought it all the way out. I followed this angle by putting another one right there. Put a straight line all the way out from the corner. I'm going to follow this angle, move my hand, and put that right there. And then from the top point, I'm going to do a straight line across. All right, and now you guys can fill it in. So if you need to fix it as you're coloring it. All right, if you need to adjust the line or fix a little piece, whatever you need to do, you can fix it as you're coloring it in. Okay, no worries, guys. No worries. You can do this. I have my utmost confidence in you. I've been taking it easy on you guys. I've been doing really happy, easy peasy paintings, you know, the gnome and the bunny and all that stuff, nice and easy peasy. So this is easy peasy too. It might seem a little tricky, but you can do it. Hey, 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 happy Friday. Tracy is in the house. Hey, Tracy. Happy Friday, love. So glad you can make it. Way to make it on time there, sweetheart. But you're here now, so that's all that counts, right? Oh, my goodness, that's too funny. All right, so we're going to do the shape of our robin next. I'll give you guys a minute to catch up mustard. I'll just pick on Tracy while you guys are ketchup mustering. Hey, hey, love, how you been? All right, so we're going in this sweet spot right here for our robin in the house. Oh, yeah. That is awesome, Tracy, right? That's like that saying, you're going to be late to your own funeral. That's me, too. I try not to be late, but that's what happens. All right, so we're going to this branch we made down here. I'm going to grab that white paint on that small brush. And the first thing you're going to do is you're going to find that sweet spot in the middle here. And you're going to swoop this way. Swoop. Just like that. So you're going to start up here. And then when you hit right where this tree branch is, you're going to curve it around and then make a line that's right above that tree branch. Okay? Right above that tree branch. And then you're going to turn around and you're going to swoop this way. So you're kind of making like a big eyeball that's laying on its side. And then you could fill it in. So you're going to start here, and when that tree branch starts getting close, you're going to make a quick turn and pull it that way. And then you're just going to swoop a line over the top and fill it in. All right, Lee is ready. There you go. So that is the shape of your bird. Remember, whenever we do anything with those how-tos, I tell you, break everything down into shapes. So that is your initial shape. Kind of looks like an eyeball on its side. Okay, so that's what you want to do for that part. And guys, I already put the spot to share your paintings on the event page, so I want to see them when they're done. I love that. I love that. And then I could schmooze it and make the post for you guys. I hope you guys enjoy the post of me sharing your work. So I go in and I fix them all so we don't see the rest of your house in the painting. And then I create those posts for you so we can share how amazing you all are. All right. So on the side of this eyeball right here, you're going to come straight up a little bit. And then you're going to curve it around. And you want your curve to stop. Like, if you were doing like the center of this point, you want your curve to stop right there, okay? Because then you're going to bring it around. And you're going to do an angled line to meet up with that part. All right, so this is a curve this way. You want to stop about midway, you know, where this part is, and then you bring it out a little bit and curve it and connect it to the part of the body right there. Oh, that's awesome, Kim. How you doing, sweetheart? You're painting rocks? That's nice. So Tom's River actually has a thing called Tom's River Rocks, and it's a community thing. Now you can just fill this in. It's a community thing where everybody puts their painted rocks in different places in the neighborhood. And then when somebody finds one, they share it on Facebook, the Facebook page, and they can turn around and rehide it. So that's amazing. All Buffalo Rocks does that too. Yeah, I think it's a really cool thing. I love it. Okay, so once you have that, where this swoops up, you're going to turn around and put the beak. So you're just going to go to where that swoop is, right here, before it starts to churn. And you're just going to move your hand, not the brush. And you're just going to put a straight line for his beak. Yeah, paint night with rocks would be actually really cool. The only problem is that they're so small. I'd have to get a really big rock to show you guys what to do. I mean, I could totally do that, but I'd have to get some really big rocks. All right, once you're done with that, you're going to come off the back of your eyeball. You're going to follow this swoop around. And then when you hit about this point, right before you get to the point, you're going to pull out. You're going to pull out. Okay, so follow this swoop around. And right there's that point of my eyeball is right here. So right above that, I'm going to pull out. Okay, I'll wipe off my brush, get rid of the globs. And then on the top part here, above where your tail is, you're going to follow this around and you're going to swoop a little triangle piece right there. Okay, so you're going to put in a little triangle piece right there. And then down here, where you put that line, you're just going to bring and connect the bottom of the eyeball to that. All right, so now you can grab your brown paint. I'm gonna grab your brown paint. And you're gonna fill in this little triangle right here. Okay, and it's all right if it mixes with the white. We're just putting our first layer colors. And if you notice, I'm just moving my brush back and forth, doing a little zigzag zoom. And then you're going to bring this up. Okay, so just doing a little zigzag zoom on here and bring it up. And then I'm going to grab my more brown paint. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to follow this. So I'm going to add, I'm actually going to grab some black and I'm going to make this back one darker. So make this triangle part darker. Okay, so I just add a little bit of black to my brown and I'm refilling that in darker. Okay, so you're going to bring it up and you're going to fill in that triangle piece darker right there. Now I'm going to wipe off my brush and I'm going to grab that brown color. And I'll follow this around like this. And I'm grabbing a little bit of white paint with that brown color, okay? So I'm going to grab a little bit of white paint, make this lighter. I'm going to follow this around. And you just put a little piece. So you bring this around till you hit where that tail part is. You go under it. And put a little piece up that way. Okay, so this I added black to my brown, and then this one I added some white to my brown. Right, so I'm grabbing some white and I'm grabbing some of that brown paint that I made, right? So that's how we make the different shades, right? We make a base color, then we add what, then we grab our white and we grab our blacks and we just make the different shades of that same color. And then you turn around and on this top part, you're just going to swoop into the belly And then bring it up and connect it there. And fill that in. Look at you guys making wings. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You guys got the skills now. You got the skills now. Making wings. You're making those wings, people. Okay, so swirl, tap, dab my brush, get all those globs out of there. I'm going to grab some black and that original brown that I made. I want it dark again, so I'm going to grab some black with that original brown. Okay, do a little smush, smush. And then on the top part of his head, from where the beak comes out, you're going to go whoop, right around. And then you're going to fill this in. And then with that same dark, dark, dark color that I made, I'm going to come in here. And I'm going to, in between where those two feathers are, I'm going to do a little ziggy-zaggy like this so I can get my brush in there. I'm going to go around that other feather. All right, so I'm going around that feather, that wing that I made. And then I'm just going to pull this out. And then when you get to this point, right, so I'm going to smush that piece in there. I'm going to smush a little piece in here. I'm going to pull this out. And then before you get to your end, you want to grab your white paint. You're going to grab some white paint on that brush. And when you get to the end, you're going to do flicks. Making, shaking your tail feathers, baby. And then where these two meet, the lighter and the darker, just go back and forth between that line. You're just going to zigzag it back and forth between that line so that blends together. Make a shaking a tail feather, honeys. Shaking a tail feather. That's what we're doing. Shaking a tail feather. Oh, yeah. I miss dancing. I wish we could go dancing. That's why I have a dance party with you guys every night. Cinder, actually, I am not making a big bird on that branch. Okay, Cinder, what are you making? What are you doing? No birds for you? Okay, and then I'm going to grab that brown color that this wing was, and I'm going to fix this up a little bit, this section. So I'm just going to follow along, and then I'm just going to do a little smush, smush to fix that part up. So I'm going to grab a little bit of white with that brown. Bye, Subi! Bye, sweetheart! Have a great night. So I'm going to grab a little bit of white with that brown, and I'm going to come over to the here, and I'm going to do little flicks and smooth that wing. Okay, so we're going to fix that up a little bit and do some little flicks there. And you want to grab some more white paint. And you're going to go to the top part of the wing. So a lot of white, the smallest amount of brown now. And you're going to go to this top part of the wing, and you're going to do flicks like this. Right? Just flicking. Just flicking in the shape of that bird. That's all I'm doing. Nice, Aaliyah. Oh, it's a surprise, Cinder. Okay. Nice, Aaliyah. See? I told you you could do it. I told you you could. All right. Now we're going to grab that white and that brown. And we're going to go under here. And you're going to fill this in. Okay, and then when you get to where the neck part is, again, you're just going to do like a little ziggy zag. Just a little ziggy zag, that's all. That's awesome, Aaliyah. I love it. I love it. Okay. You know, and you guys can play around adding, you know, adding little flicks and adding, you know, like on this back wing, I took that lighter brown and I added some flicks to the bottom part of it, you know, and then where the colors are supposed to join together, you just do a little back and forth. Just do a little back and forth. So I put some flicks there. Now I'm grabbing the darker brown. Schmoozing that up a little bit. You know, now you're just schmoozing and playing. That's all you're doing. That's all you're doing. Just schmoozing and playing. All right. Swirl, tap, dab your brush. That's awesome, Aaliyah. I love it. So swirl, tap, dab your brush, and we're going to make our orange. All right. So I'm going to swirl, tap, dab my brush, and I'm going to grab my yellow and my red. Grab my yellow and my red. I'm going to make a nice orange color. Because even though they call it a red-breasted robin, it's actually a little, it's red. I mean, it's like a dark orange. So a lot of red, a little bit of yellow. Make a nice dark orangey color. And come back in here and fill in this whole part. Okay? And where the neck and this meet, you just want to do like a little zigzag back and forth like that. Just a little zigzag zoom. Okay, follow this wing around. And then when you get to this part where that little crook is in his feather right here, you're going to do a little zigzag zoom there. Just going to do a little zigzag back and forth. Right? And then you could fill in the rest. So I'm just using that flat of my brush, and I'm following along the line here, making sure this stays straight above that branch, parallel to that branch, right? If you get a little bit of globs, just push them in with your finger. It's all good. And we're just going to color this in. That's all we're doing. We're just coloring, people. You guys got this. You can color. And if this part is see-through for you, leave it alone. Don't put globs and globs of paint on it. So, you know, leave it alone, and then we can go back and do a second coat on it, okay, guys? So that's a little see-through on you. And I'm just doing little flick motions like this, so it looks like it has a little bit of feathery texture to it. And if it's a little see-through, that's okay. That's what happens with the yellow and the red. Just leave it alone, let it dry, and we can go back and do a second coat. All right? And make sure you don't have any globs on your brush, because if you have globs on your brush, you're going to get globs on your painting. I'm going to come in and I'm going to do his beak. I'm going to fill in his beak right here. Okay, nice and careful, nice and slow, no worries. And then I'm going to fill in my birdhouse. So I'm going to grab... I'm going to grab that orangey color that I made. I'm going to add a little bit more yellow to it, make it really orangey, orangey, orangey. And I'm going to do the front of my birdhouse. So, following those lines. And I just added a little more yellow to the orange that I did the bird with. I'm going to map out all my lines on here. nice and easy. Okay, so I'm going to put all my lines on here nice and easy. I'm going to do that first. I'm going to do that first, and then I'm going to color that in. We're just coloring, people. We're coloring. And I'm going to hold my brush back here, and I'm just going to do, like, flicking coloring, pulling the paint down. So if you see me, I'm going like this, and I'm holding my brush in the back, because this way it'll give it, like, an old wood texture. All right? So I'm just going to flick this all around and move it around, and then, you know, you can grab just the orange, and you can just, I'm just doing like little flicky motions, holding my brush at the back of my brush and smushing this in and letting it stay separated with its pieces of color so it looks like old wood. Okay, so I'm going to do that side, and then we're going to do this side. So I'm going to grab that red and that yellow, and I'm actually going to grab the smallest, tiny smallest amount of black paint, like you barely grabbed any black paint at all. And I'm going to go to that yellow and that red, and I'm going to smush that around a bit. I'm not going to overmix it. I'm just going to smush this around a little bit, get all the different colors on here. Okay, so I'm grabbing the yellow and the red and the smallest amount of black, tiny amount of black, and I'm smushing it together, and I'm getting all the separation of color on my brush. So I'm going to grab that, I'm going to grab the yellow, and I'm going to grab the red. I'm going to do a little dab. And then I'm going to fill in the other side. And I'm following the direction of my birdhouse, if you noticed. Okay, and this is going to make all these little dark things happen over here. It's going to make all these little variation of dark little lines and little happy things going on. Just adding that little bit of black paint. Okay, just adding that little bit of black paint. It's gonna make all this happy stuff happen without me even trying. It's painting magic. And if you grab too much black, if you're losing all the other stuff, just wipe your brush off. Grab the red and yellow. Cinder, now I want to know what the surprise is, because you said you weren't doing a bird on your branch. I want to know what the surprise is now. Just grab your red and yellow, and then you can smush around with the red and yellow. If you wound up having it too dark or too brown, you know, too black, too much black going in there, whatever it is that happened to you. If you go over your line, that's what spit's for. Right? That's what spit's for. And besides, this birdhouse is outlined, so you don't have to worry about your edges too much. Okay? You don't have to worry about your edges too much with that bad boy. Look at you guys, right? Painting robins, painting birdhouses. Look at you go, right? So we're going to turn around. And all we got to do is we're going to finish up filling these colors in. We're going to add some more fun to our branches. And then we're going to be all set. So this is amazing. You guys are doing amazing. Aaliyah's husband actually said it looks like a bird. So that's a score. Let me shake you guys up a bit. Let's do some roll call. We have Nancy, Diane, Jack, Cinder, Kim, and Ella are here. Peggy, Magna, Sandy, and Nikhil. Ginny with her granddaughter Audrey's in the house. Lynn from Ohio. Angela's hanging out. Aaliyah's. Husband thinks her bird looks like a bird. Cynthia, Soupy was here. She had to leave us, though. Sad, sad. Tammy M is here, sending all of our prayers to you and your family. We have Calpana, Lisa, and Tracy. Late Tracy. Tracy went from being Creeper Tracy to Late Tracy. Oh, goodness gracious. I've got to think of a different name. All right. So now that we have that, now we're going to turn around and we're going to take Tiny. We're going to take Tiny. So we're going to take our Tiny brush and we're going to go grab that brown and that black. So I'm going to grab some black paint and I'm going to grab that brown paint and I'm going to roll my brush, giving myself a nice point. And now you can go in, now that you know where your birdhouse and your bird are, now you can go in and add those other little branches in. So, hi Nova, how you doing, sweetheart? Welcome to the fam. Hello, sweetheart. Hello, hello, hello. Right, Diane? That's totally true. All right, so now that I have this small amount of paint on here, I'm going to turn around and, like, out the side of my tree, like right here, holding like a pencil. Make sure you're not putting your hand on a wet paint as you're holding it. And very lightly, I'm just going to do a little squiggle lines like that. All right, and Tiny is not a marker. The harder you press, more paint isn't going to come out. You have to constantly reload the brush and constantly check to make sure you have a point. All right, make sure, and then I'm going to follow that line along and put another squiggly line in. Okay, wipe off my brush. Reload it with paint. So this is constant brush care when you do this. You constantly have to look at your brush and make sure there's a point on it. Make sure you're wiping those globs off of your brush. All right, do another little squiggle off of that. And you're just coming right out the side of your tree because this is like a branch that's behind the tree. And you want to make sure this is thicker and these are thinner. So if this came out thick, just follow along back and make it thicker, thicker, and thicker. Right? And again, I am wiping off my brush now. And I'm going to reload it with paint. If you have to give it a little swirl tap dab, do that too. Okay? You want to make sure that you have a point. And the paint is nice and thin on your brush. So you got to make sure all those things are in place for yourself. And I'm going to come down here to this one we made. And I'm going to follow along and then just do some squiggles out from that. Follow along, do some squiggles out on that one. Okay, so you can add these tiny little branches wherever you want them to be. Just make sure you keep checking that brush. Just make sure you keep checking that brush. And I'm just making this dark brown. I'm making these all dark brown. All right, so wherever you want these to be, you can turn around and create these little fun, happy little twigs and branches. Like I said, see how that came out a little thick on me? So I'm going to follow down. I'm going to make this thicker. I'm going to make that thicker. Okay, so you just want to even it out. So if you wind up with a thick one, it's all right, no worries. Just make your branch thicker so it looks like you did it on purpose. Right? Make sure you just, it looks like you did it on purpose. That's all there is to it, guys. All right, that's all. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to do. All right, so I'm adding all these in. No worries here. No mistakes. There's no mistakes in art, right? That's right. I'm going to go off of my big branch that the bird is on, and I'm going to follow along my branch, and then I'm just going to pull some squiggles out of it. file along my branch, pull some squiggles. Very technical here. We're squiggling. We're squiggling, people. That's what we're doing. File along my branch, do some squigglies. Okay, filling in my branch better if I need to. Just pulling the paint along. Adding a little bit of texture to my branch. Getting all that excess paint off my brush. Refilling, re-rolling. Adding some more. Right, wherever you want your little branches to be. Wherever you want your little flowers to be. I'm going to the one the birdhouse is on. I'm going to follow along and pull out. So I'm going to do that, and you guys can't see what I did. There we go. So I'm just going to follow along and then pull my brush out. Making all these little happy twigs. All right, so we need to, because we need something for our flowers to be hanging out on. I'm going to go to the one all the way up top, which is in the shadow, but you guys get the gist already. So I'm just going to put some branches coming out from that. And remember, if you make a thick one, just go thicker, thicker, and thicker all the way back to the tree so you can fix it. That's all. That's all you need to do. Hi, Kim. How you doing, sweetie? I'm going to come down here and add some coming out down here. All right, so you guys, as you're doing these, think about what color you want your flowers to be, you know, like how, you know, like mine are yellow and red, so you can think about what colors that you want your flowers to be on your tree. It's all up to you. Right, you can put your branches wherever you want them to be, that's all up to you. You know, however many you're going to add or do, it's all up to you. It's your tree. It's your world. Hey, if you have a piece of your cloud that you messed up, guess what? Put a branch over it. Put a branch over it. That's all you need to do. That's how we roll here. That's how what we do on Eve's Creations. We just, if we mess something up, we're just going to paint something on top of it. That's the way it works. All right, so we're going to go back in. We're going to grab Mini-Me. We're going to grab Mini-Me, which was my small flat brush, and we're going to do the roof of the birdhouse because that should be dry by now. So we're going to do the details on our birdhouse. So I'm going to grab that brown. I'm going to grab that brown, and I'm going to grab that black. And I'm going to grab some Ucky White. So I want this to be like a brownish gray color. Right? I want it to be like a brown, like a browny grayish color. Okay? I'm not going to overmix it. I don't want to overmix it because I want the brush to do that separation of color magic for me. So I'm just kind of smooshing the paint in there, getting the different colors in there. Black, brown, and white. Just kind of smoosh it around. Take that paint and you're going to fill in your roof. But what I want you to do is I want you to turn around and follow this line down and then you're going to extend it over. You're going to put it over and then pull it across. Right? And then you're going to take this line and then you're going to meet up with that one. So you want an overhang. All right, so I took this and I pulled it over, went into the side of the house, take this, match that up to the same size, went straight across, and now I can fill it in. Now I can fill it in. So you want that little bit of overhang. And I'm just going to follow the direction of my roof with my brush strokes. Okay, let all that separation of color happen. If you want to grab your You know, you can grab just your brown if you want to, put the, some of that in, right? Make that roof line going across so you don't go out of your lines, because I'm famous for that. So we're going to do our roof line going across. And I'm just going to go the direction of my roof and make all this fun stuff happen. Grabbing white, grabbing black, grabbing brown. Whatever. Whatever. Let whatever magic is on the brush happen for you. It's all good. Just let it go. Let it go. Let's see what happens, right? Just let it go. No worries. No worries here. We're just painting little birdhouses, hanging out as a family, partying on a Friday night, making memories, right? With our friends and our granddaughters and our... Hi, Nova! I make it look so simple. Of course it's simple. You guys got this. No worries. You guys got this. You guys are champs. I'm telling you, you can do this. You got it, Aaliyah? You got the colors? All right. And I'm going to wipe off my brush because it's a big globby mess. And then I'm going to come down the other side of my house. And then extend that line over a little bit. Okay. Hi, sweetheart. Extend that a little bit. All right, and wipe off my brush. And now I'm going to grab, notice I'm not cleaning it. I'm just wiping it off so you get all the globs off of it. That's all. So now I'm going to grab white paint. And I'm going to grab that brown, and I'm going to make it nice and light, colored, and I'm going to go in the front here, and I'm going to make this lighter. We're going to make that lighter, and we're going to make this side lighter. All right? And you guys have to yell at me. I'm painting with globs of paint on my brush, and I'm getting globs on my painting. Oh, it's all good, Noah. It's all good. If you need me to repeat anything, let me know. And the replays are always available. So I'm just grabbing white paint and adding it and making that front pieces of the roof there. That's all I'm doing. All I'm doing. I'm gonna grab my brown. I'm gonna fix this edge up a little bit. Put a little more, couple more little swoosh, smush, smushes in here. Add to my texture. Make it look like wood. Fix my points. Get it all nicey nice. Now I'm gonna grab just black paint. Just black, and we're going to do parentheses and parentheses. Put our little hole in there so the birdie can go in his house. And then I'm going to grab a little bit of that black and brown. And I'm going to put the perch in, so you're going to do a straight line out, just like that. All right, and then we're going to add a little bit of detail to it with tiny. So for now, just put the line, all right? Don't worry about anything. Just put the line for now, okay? So you're going to start, there's the center of your circle. You're going to bring it down, and that's where you're going to start your perch. And I just dragged paint. So I'm going to just, that's what spit's for, guys. You ever get paint where you don't want it, hit it with a little spit on your finger and rub it out. That's what that's for. That's why God created saliva, to fix our artwork. That's how that works, people. But I'm talking so much, I don't have any spit left in my mouth. That's what happens. But that's okay. It's all good. It's all good. Alright, so we're going to grab our tiny brush. We're going to grab our tiny brush. We're going to put the details in our robin. If you need to do the second coat on the... If you need to do the second coat on the chest piece, do that now. Right, so if you need to do your second coat of your robin chest piece because of the little see-through before. So I'm going to grab my, I'm going to clean off my mini-me. And I'm going to go back into that yellows and those reds that I made. And I'm going to come up to my chest piece here. And you just want to do, in the direction, you just want to, you know, fill that in a little bit better. Doing little flicks, giving that little bit of texture like it's feathery. Right? So you want to fill that in. If you need to do a second coat on your beak, you can do that. Right? If you need to schmooze a little on your birdhouse with these colors on there, you can do that. Alright, so now I'm going to grab Tiny, and we're going to do all our little details, and then we're going to do our flowers, and we're going to be all set, guys. So if you have any questions, ask me. I'm just rolling right along. If I'm going too fast, just be like, Eve, stop! Too fast! Hi, Andrej. How you doing? I hope I said your name right. Hi! Alright, so I'm taking Tiny. You know what else Spit's good for? I take Tiny and I fix them like that to get them nice and pointy. Put my heart, soul, and Spit into my paintings, people. You buy an Eve's Artistry painting, you're getting a little piece of her. You get a very little of all levels. All right, I'm taking Tiny and I'm going to grab my white paint. Right, Aaliyah? I'm telling you. And we're going to go into this bottom part here. And we're just going to fill that in nicer. And do little flicks into your orange. Do little flicks into your orange. Just like that. Alright, if you go over your feather a little bit, then just put your put your wing back in, right? No big deal. No big deal. That's right, Kim. Alright, I'm going to grab my white paint again. And I'm going to come up in here. And very, very lightly, I'm going to put a circle where his eyeball goes. Do some white paint like this. And then I'm just going to smush it with my finger to soften it out. So just give it a little smush smush with your finger. That's right, Nova. It's all good. We put our heart, soul, and saliva into our artwork. That's just the way it works out, people. It's just the way it works out. I'm going to clean off my brush. And I'm going to grab my black paint. And grab my black paint. Now, if it's getting goopy on you, you just add a little bit of water to it. If your black paint's getting goopy, or if any of your paint's getting goopy, just add a little bit of water to it. Soften it right out. If it has a skin on the top of it, just move that skin over. Don't push it into your paint. Just move it over. So I'm grabbing my black paint. I'm getting a nice point on here. Getting a nice point on here. I'm going to come down to this part where his legs come out. So you're going to put those coming out at an angle. So right where this red part is, you want to move up a little bit, like right here in this sweet spot right there. And you're just going to put a line coming out at an angle like that. And then you can put his little toes onto the branch. Right, wipe off my brush, get a thin amount of paint again, So this one, you see where it connects to the body. You go into the body with that one a little bit. And then the other one, you want to go under the body because that's the leg on the other side. You're going to pull that down. And then you can put his three little toes in that part. Okay? So one you put into the body and come out. And then the other one you stop at the body and come out because that's on the other side. And I'm going to come in and I'm going to do a little circle in here of the black. So you can still see the white, but now he has a black eyeball right there. And then I'm going to take my black paint and I'm going to outline my birdhouse. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to just follow my lines here. Move your hand, not the brush. You notice I'm putting my brush in my spot that I want. Let me do this so you can see what I'm doing. So I'm putting my brush in the spot I want. Then I'm going to move my hand, not the brush. Right? Put your brush in the spot that you want. I'm moving my hand, not the brush. Okay? Pull this line all the way across. And then over here, put it in the spot that I want, and I'll move my hand, not the brush. That's how you get a nice straight line, guys. And if you have a little bit of shake, just do it faster. You gotta like outrun your shake. And if you mess up, do what Nova's telling you to do. Right, Nova? Use a little bit of spit. Use a little bit of spit. Okay, swirl tap dab that tiny off. Get all that black out of them. Make your point on your brush. Make sure you clean it off first. I'm going to grab a little bit of that brown color that I did the roof with. Let me move you guys closer up, okay, so you can see these details on this house. Here we go. Close up. I'm going to go into that perch piece, and on the end of it, we're going to just do a little circle. Right? Telling you guys, I don't make nothing up here, guys. This is what you need to do, right? So I'm going to do a little circle on the end of this perch piece right here and fill that in with the brown. And then I'm gonna grab a little bit of my black, smallest amount. Like, I don't know if you guys can see this, but like, there's hardly any paint on this brush. Just a little bit black on the tip. And I'm gonna turn around on this side and curve that. Add a little bit of curve to that side. So this side you're curving, and then this side you're putting a little circle in for your perch, okay? And then I'm going to grab my paint of my, the color of my paint for the roof. I'm going to come into my circle here. I'm going to start at the halfway mark and then just pull around. So you're kind of seeing the side of the wall inside that hole. And if you went a little excited, if you got a little excited and put too much brown in, right? If it's not on just one side of your circle, you can grab your black paint again and just smooch it up. So I always wind up putting these in and then I gotta fix them because I went a little too far. So I'm just gonna grab a little bit of black paint and refix that. All right, if you take it a little too far, just grab your black paint and you can follow along and you can fix that. It's not that big of a deal. Because I always wind up getting happy with that edge piece and then I mess it all up. Bye, Magna. Bye, Sanvi. Bye, Nikhil. Bye, guys. Enjoy your pizza. I'm so jealous. Enjoy. All right, so we only have two things left to do. Well, three. My bad. So you want to take that tiny brush with that black paint. And you're going to put in the anchors for the birdhouse on your tree. Okay, again, move your hand, not the brush. So you want to just go from the point of your ceiling here, and you're just going to pull a line to that part, and then you're going to go to the other side, the back top part here, this corner, and you're just going to pull a line to connect to that. And then on the top of these, hi, Mom! My mom is on here, everybody. Say hi to Mom. Hi, Mom. Hello. So my mom's up from Florida today, right now. She's in Jersey. So once you draw those two lines, you just want to give like a little hook. Just want to give a little hook to it. That's all. Okay. Hi, Mom. That's right, Nova. So, in case you guys didn't know, my mom is 83, and she can run circles around me. Mm-hmm. Gotta love her. That's right, Cynthia. Everyone's saying hi to you, Mom. Okay. Now we're going to clean off that tiny brush. And we're going to grab some white paint just on the top point of it, just the top point. Right, Lynn? I know, right, Nova? So Mom, Cynthia says hi, Lynn says hi, Nova's saying hi. All right, so I'm putting white paint just on the tip of that brush. I'm going to go to that black eyeball that I made. And this is called a life dot. So you just want to add this little dot right to the side of your black, and that just makes your eyeball come alive. I call it a life dot right there. Bink, just a little dot. And then we're going to get Mini Me out, and we're going to do our flowers. Kim's saying hello, Mom. Hiya, Kim. How's Ella doing? I hope Ella's doing all right. Ha-ha. Mom says, love you all, fam. You're the best, Mom. I love you. She's the best. Oh, awesome, Kim. I'm glad Ella's doing really good. So I got my mom saying the word fam. I think that's awesome. All right, so you guys want to pick what colors you want your flowers. And we're going to take Mini Me, that flat brush. And you just want to grab white in that color. You want to grab white in that color. So Kim says, how sweet. Hi, Eve's mom. We all appreciate your daughter sharing her talents with us. Thank you so much, Kim. That was very sweet of you. Thank you so much for that. All right, so I'm going to grab Mini Me, which is that squared off brush we've been using all night. I'm going to grab some white, and I'm going to grab some yellow. Because my flowers are going to be yellow and red. I don't know about your flowers. And you just want to do dabs. And they don't have to be attached to the branch. So you can do these dabs here, there, not everywhere, right? You just put these dabs in. And they don't have to be connected to a branch. If you mess the branch up, 6,000% put a flower over it. 6,000% put a flower over it. And you're just going to do these dabs. So this tree is going to be my yellow tree. Right? So make sure you add your colors to the right branch to the tree. Right, so make sure that if you're making one yellow, you only add yellow flowers to the branches that are on that tree. All right, so we're going to do yellow here. I'm going to come down here and do yellow around this one. If you notice, I'm just doing these dabs here, there, not everywhere. And I'm doing some that are floating. They're not even connected. So you can do the floating flowers. grabbing yellow and white. So let me know what colors you guys are picking for your flowers. Let me know what colors you got going on. I want to know. All right, so this is this tree. So that's the only branches I have coming from this tree. All right, so that's the only, oh no, I have this one over here, the bird's on. All right, so follow your tree and follow which branches are coming off that tree so you know where to put your flowers. And if you messed up a branch, 6,000% put a flower over it. But you don't have to put these connecting to anything. You just put them here, there, not everywhere. Okay, as many or as little as you'd like, whatever you want to do. And keep in mind, you're going to do a second coat over these. Because right now you're doing the white in the color. This way it has a base, so when you put the color over it, it's going to pop. So, you know, don't make 6,000 of them, because you're going to have to turn around and fill them all in again. You're going to have to fill them all in again. All right, so here, there, not everywhere. Wherever you want them to be. And like I said, if you messed up a branch, put a flower over it. All right, so I'm going to swirl tap dab my brush. And I'm going to grab my white and my red. Do a little smush smush. And I'm going to follow this tree. So this branch has the flowers coming off of it. Right here, there, not everywhere. There we go, right there. And then I'm going to follow this tree, and this branch is coming off of it, so I'm going to do the flowers here. And if there's a part in your cloud you messed up, then 6,000% put a flower over it. Right? That's what I'm talking about. And I'm just using white and red. So whatever colors you guys are doing your flowers, just do white and that color together. And I'm going to follow my tree up. And this branch is coming off of my tree. So I'm going to come in here and do these flowers. So you can go on your branch and then you can go off of your branch and put a few floaters. You know, it's completely up to you. And like I said, if you messed up part of your branch, put a flower over it. That's what we do. Bye, Aaliyah. See you soon. Aw, thank you, Mom. Mom says thank you all for supporting my awesome daughter. Aw, thank you, guys. Aw, you're all warming my heart. Thank you so much. Thanks, Mom. I love you bunches. I love you bunches. Have a good night, Aaliyah. All right, so I'm following my tree up, and this branch is coming off of my tree. So I'm going to put my flowers with this branch. All right, so just make sure whatever flowers you're doing, you're putting it on the right branch connected to the right tree. And I know you can't see this with the shadow, so let me lift this up a bit. Yep. Let me lift this up a bit. There you go. Now you can see the top of my canvas. All right? And I'm just doing these smushes. That's all I'm doing. Here, there, not everywhere. Here, there, not everywhere. Okay, you put some on your branch, put some off the branch, floating around. Cinder, you're the best. Hey, Mom, did you know your daughter is an awesome goober? You're a goober too, Cinder. That's why I love you. All right. So, we got two more steps left, people. Home stretch. Home stretch. So now that I have those in there, I'm going to take my tiny brush with my brown and my black. Right? Give it a little swirl. Thank you, Cynthia. Yes, Kim, it'll work out on a different size canvas. Just make sure you're in the general area of your canvas that I'm in. And it'd probably be easier for you if you do 11 by 14 or 16 by 20, because then you're going to have more width to play with. So you're going to have more canvas to play with to position your things just the way you want them. So a bigger canvas will be fine. So I'm going to show you a close-up, and you're going to use that brown, that black, and where you put your flowers on your twigs. We'll do this one right here. Now you're going to go in, and you're just going to, like, maybe put a line over one of your flowers. You put another line connecting to your flower here. So you're just adding little twigs that are going to connect your flowers. And then set some in the back and some in the front. So you're just going to do these little lines, right? And they don't have to connect to every single one. You're just kind of putting a little knot in that there is... it's connected to the tree. All right, so I'm going to do the one on the other side. I'm going to do the one on the other side. Up, there's the butters. He's talking to us. Okay, I'm just going to put these, and then you can put some of your lines over your flowers. Like that. Butters! Right? So this way you get them all to look. Yes, it'll look fine. Yep, Kim, so another canvas that'll look fine. You got it. Right, so I'm going to go to this branch here, and I'm just going to put little, so you could put one going like right over your flower to set that into the back. Okay. So you want to, you could put some going right over your flower. You could put some back behind the flowers. You know, like I said, they don't have to connect to a branch like completely. You're just kind of giving a nod and setting them some of them in the background and some of them in the foreground by adding branches going over the top of some of them. So if you put a branch going over the top of some of your flower petals, it'll make it look like it has dimension. That's all we're doing here, guys. That's all we're doing. We're adding a little dimension. That's all. So I'm going to add some that are going over the top of the petals. Or maybe put one back in that was over the top of the petal. And when you do that, you're just adding dimension. You're making it like some of the petals are in the back and some of them are in the front of the tree. That is awesome. Cinder Cheesecake is answering Butters. That's so funny. Oh my goodness, that's adorable. Yes, Nova, that's what we're doing. So we're adding a little bit of dimension, and we're just putting some of the petals going behind it. Right? So see these petals right here? I'm going to draw a line, and I'm going to set that petal in the background. So when you draw the line over it, you set the petal in the background. And then some of them you can keep in front of the branches. So this way, you're giving it a little bit more dimension. That's all you're doing. Yes, Mom, goober. That's what Cinder calls me. I'm a goober. Just a silly person. We embrace our silliness around here. And Cinder's dog, she has two puppies, and they're called Applesauce and Cheesecake. So, how amazing is that? So, she's a goober, too. Because we're just silly, silly, silly. All right, so now I'm going to take my mini-me, and I'm going to go back, and I'm going to put the colors right over my... the colors I wanted over some of these petals. So I'm going to come back here with just red, And I'm going to add just red to some of these. Not necessarily all of them. Because some of them... might have a little pink tone to them. So I'm just going to add a little bit of red to all my pink ones out here. And like I said, not necessarily all of them. You know, you can leave some pink. You don't have to do all. You can just do a little smush on it. So a piece of it's red and a piece of it's pink. That's fine too. That's fine too. So I'm just kind of putting here, there, not everywhere, just putting darker color on some of these, and some of them I'm leaving alone, you know, just giving it a little variation going on. That's all I'm doing. Just smushing my colors here, putting some here, some there, some everywhere. And then I'm going to swirl tap dab my brush and go back in with just my yellow. We'll go just back in with the yellow now. And this is just going to make them pop more, make them a little darker. And give a little nod to spring that things are blooming. Kind of reminds me of a forsythia with the yellow. My forsythia bloomed already. Everybody, so that's it. You guys did it. You painted Hello Spring Rockin' Robin 6000%. So I just want to thank you all for joining me tonight, and I love you all, fam. I think you're all amazing. I hope you had a lot of fun doing this painting. Those of you that are watching the replay, welcome, and I hope you enjoyed your replay. It's always free to watch. Tips and gratuities are appreciated. I just posted the links. Good night, Cynthia. Bye, sweetheart. So, I just want to tell you that y'all warm my heart. Thank you for joining me, and remember to have fun and go create. Okay? So, everybody have a good night. Good night, Nova. Bye, sweetheart. Thank you for joining me tonight. Thank you. And I'll see you guys all on Tuesday. How to Tuesday is going to be wings. We're going to learn all about wings. Bye, Kim. Two Kims on here. Bye, guys. Bye, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me. We're all done, Mom. We're all set. That's the end of the show. You know what's really cool is my apron has pockets, so I can put my hands in my pockets. My looking official apron. Bye, Ginny. Bye, Audrey. Bye, guys. Bye, sweethearts. Ginny, you were creep. Oh, there you go. Good night, everybody. Okay, Cinder, I can't wait to see your surprise. You said you weren't doing your little robin, so I can't wait to see what your surprise is. And I know you take a couple of days. You like to get it just so. Yes, Kim, I'm going to post the replay as soon as I end the live feed with you guys. Okay? And the replay will be on the event page. It'll be on my business page. Eventually, they'll be on YouTube. Still working on it. All right, sweetie, so you guys can watch the replay if you're just hanging out, watching me paint, and you can give it a whirl. You guys got this. I know you got mad skills. Good night, everybody. Good night, Nancy. Good night, Diane, Jack, and Cinder, and Kim, and Ella, and Peggy. And good night, Lynn, and Angela, and Aaliyah, Cynthia, Sue, Tammy, Kalpana, Tracy, Lisa, Nova. Good night, everybody. You all warm my heart. Thank you for joining me, fam. Thanks, Mom. All right, so anybody watching the replay, if you have any questions, feel free to message me, and y'all warm my heart. I appreciate you watching me, and don't forget, tips are appreciated. Art supplies aren't free, and I'll see you all next time, okay? Y'all warm my heart. Mwah. Good night. Bye.